one there on the corner.
That would be good.
You kind of have an idea why I called you in to talk?
Yeah.
Okay.
Can I ask you something before we go in there?
Absolutely.
One, did you tell my brother?
I did talk to your brother the other day.
Yeah, he said, but I mean, did you tell him what it was about?
No. Nope. I told him just as a courtesy that I needed to visit with you, and I said what it was, but no detail of anything. So beyond that, no, I did not talk about that at all. So I'm just going to get a recorder started here and get some preliminary stuff going with that. This will be a recorded statement reference case number 127488. Bambi, if you would state your full name and date of birth, please.
Bambi Joy Alexander, 527-75.
All right. And I have an address for you at 105 North McKay in Alexandria, that's correct?
Yes.
And your cell is 815-3555?
Yes.
All right. Before we begin, just so you know, at this time, you're not in trouble, okay? When we're done talking here today, you're going to get up and walk out of this room and go about your day. You understand that?
Yes.
Okay. And if at any time during our conversation you say, I've had enough, I want to go, you're free to get up and walk out of here. I'm not going to stop you from doing that. Do you understand that?
Yes.
Okay. Why is it that you think you're here today?
My appointment with the city of Carlos.
Okay. And what about the city of Carlos?
Accusations that have been made against me.
Such as?
Missing money.
Okay. And how do you respond to that?
I guess considering the accusations, I can only do say so much today without probably contacting the lawyer yet.
Okay.
But I don't want to be uncooperative.
Sure. And understand that how you choose or what you choose to talk about today, I'm not going to consider whether you're uncooperative or cooperative. Okay? This is my chance to visit with you about the information that I have. Okay? And you can make, you know, decide how you want to proceed with it from here. Basically, today is your opportunity to tell me your side. The Minnesota State Auditor's Office has done an investigation. I've gotten those results. I talked to the city clerk, and her name is escaping
Marcia.
Me right now. Yes, thank you, Marcia. And the next step is to talk to you and find out kind of what happened. And so when you say there's accusations of missing money, what does that mean?
Well, I mean, I know a city person that lives in the town accused me of that.
Okay.
So, that was about a town meeting, I wasn't there.
Mm-hmm.
It happened. Whether he's completely correct on what he said, I don't know.
Okay.
I really don't. I don't know what to say right now. I really don't. I want to make things right.
Mm-hmm.
But if this all comes out somehow in a bad way, I'm not going to be able to make it right.
Okay. Do you know the amount of money we're talking about? $34,639.31. And those are all in Carlos City checks out of the general fund and the utility fund that have been written out to you.
Yeah.
So, guess, and this is just a guess, my experience in dealing with this stuff is that there's a financial burden in your life, something that you've been dealing with, okay, and you had an opportunity in your position as treasurer to probably get some money, pay off some debt or whatever you have personally going on, and then at some point you're going to replenish that money to the city of Carlos. Is that accurate?
Pretty much.
Yeah. And things just kind of snowballed and got further out of control than you planned.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for sharing that with me. That's kind of the nuts and bolts of why we needed to meet today.
I know. And I knew it was coming.
Yeah.
And I don't. I got the wrong person.
Okay.
And I lost everything I had. I was two kids. I'm taking care of myself. And it just isn't who I am, never have been.
Sure.
I don't know how I let myself do it.
Well, I think probably at some point, like I said earlier, there was an opportunity there, and you think to yourself, okay, I'll just take a little bit now when I can make it right. No, but sometimes we're able to justify things that way.
I never was that person. I just went to myself. Okay. The problem is I have a job. A decent job. It's an accounting job. And I am a good accountant. And I was a good accountant. But unfortunately, this comes out, they can fire me.
Sure. Well, at this point, when you say, if this comes out, I'm not going to be calling your boss and saying, guess who I talked to last night.
But I'm charged.
At some point, yeah, you're going to have to to deal with this up front criminally.
Okay.
And, you know, it's a substantial amount of money to do that. Well, how did this happen? What got you to this point and how were you getting the money from Carlos?
I just, like I said, I got involved with a very wrong person. I was supporting him.
Okay.
And it got worse and worse. And I just let it keep going.
And when you say it got worse and worse financially?
Yeah.
Worse and worse?
Yeah.
Okay. Are we talking like credit card or gambling or drinking or what?
He just wasn't working and
so based on your income, you were supporting yourself, this guy, and two kids.
And then I stopped it, and he broke up with me shortly after that.
Okay.
So I found out that I was pretty much being used for that. And I tried to get ahead, and I ended up moving the house in Carlos because of it. I had my car repossessed twice. I don't have it.
Okay.
Every time our electricity was shut off, they had no heat in the wintertime. And I know that's how it first started. I just thought if I could pay this one bill, and then everything kept happening.
Sure.
My son ended up becoming a dad of twins at 15, and he had the preemies, and all the expenses of that, and he got taken to court. It spiraled out of control.
Okay. How long have you been taking money from Carlos?
Honestly, I couldn't answer that specifically. I think it was over a year or two. Yeah, I honestly don't
know. So about 1 to 2 years thinking?
I mean, I know it was probably more like a year and a half to two, but I don't know.
And how is it that you, what were you specifically doing to get the money?
Well, the way, you know, the schedule was sometimes is when my shift was at the office and Rick's shift was at the office. You know, we'd have, I'd have her sign checks because I knew I was going to be doing a check run, and I wouldn't see her, and then it hurries up the process because we also have to get the mayor to sign them. Sometimes it can take a while when people are waiting for checks, but there's always my check.
As I understand it from my conversation with her, is that she would work like a Monday evening,
yeah,
and then you would work a Wednesday evening? Okay. So you would have invoices prepared, and she would sign the check. It would come back to you on Wednesday then? On
actually,
Wednesday evening, or?
Well, that's the other thing. You know, I've been the treasurer since 1999. Marsha and me were friends, but I'm sure we're not anymore.
Okay.
We're really good friends. And I put her in a position where I'm flying to her eventually. I mean, it's not how it started. We've been doing it for a long time that way.
Okay.
But when it...
So you had the...
They were blank. So.
They were blank checks. But she would sign them because some of them were only signed by two people versus the required three, some of the checks. And some of the checks had all three signatures.
Three signature ones should be my actual paycheck.
Okay.
I don't think I ever took
okay.
anything that was them.
But the other ones, she would sign them first because she worked Monday night and then Tuesday night.
Yeah.
Were the checks completed? Or just signed?
Just signed.
Okay.
And it's just for the record that she knew nothing about this, that she doesn't know what she was signing or what she was getting herself into by signing a blank check. She had absolutely zero responsibility for this.
Okay. So what she would do is, would she even have an invoice attached, or would she just sign some
no,
checks?
No, I kind of go through what I had for bills, and I'll say, well, I need this many and this many. And
who actually had the checks?
I did. They're in the box.
Okay. So you would have those. You would leave, if you knew there were six invoices, you would leave Marsha six checks.
Yeah.
She would sign them. Then you would get them. And that was, then what would you do?
Well, then, like I said, most of the time, I ran the bills on Wednesday, and then I'd leave them for her to sign as well.
Okay.
So then that would save the time. So like I said, it, I know the very first time it happened, it was because our heat was shut off.
Okay.
And it was wintertime, and I had to pay the bill.
Sure.
I didn't know what else to do.
So Marsha would sign them, you'd come in on Wednesday evening, and then you would fill out the rest of the check, and some of those times, they were written to
whom?
Okay. So you would just write them out to yourself, sign yourself, and then be able to cash them. You said the first time it went to pay a heat bill.
Mm-hmm.
Of the many times over a year and a half, where did, what was the rest of the money used for?
Like I said, they had heating bills more than once.
Okay.
Electricity had been shut off.
Would you say, would it be fair to say they were bills that needed to be paid?
Yeah.
Okay.
When my car got repossessed, it cost me $1,500 to get it back.
Credit card?
I never have
bills.
Cards.
Okay. Were there some that were, I mean, $1,500 in the scope of things isn't a lot of money?
No.
But were there some much larger
expenses? I don't think there
expenses?
Was any one huge thing.
Okay.
Like said, my husband upstairs has been too stressed, paying child support. My daughter, she's in jail volleyball. It's extremely expensive. The fees make anywhere from $500 to $700. They travel to hotels. During the winter, I mean, it wasn't logical stuff eventually. It just...
So with some of the expenses that went along with...
I still can't afford, my bills. So it's not like I made my life any better. It just came on and then made it worse.
Sure. Okay. You talked about just a minute ago your son had some premature children, and there were some lawyer fees with that. Okay. Were there some hospital fees that you also paid?
No, they're all on. The twins are on MA.
Okay.
But she fought, so that hospital couldn't see him.
Was it like a custody type? Okay. And so you covered some of those costs?
Yeah, I had to cover for Austin.
Okay. What attorney would that have been
through? Peg.
Okay. Is it Doug?
Yeah. And even that, I only paid some of it. It wasn't even that much, honestly. It did go by my income. The rest, I think, ended up coming on a Department of Revenue.
Okay.
I also, a big chunk, I had my car stolen 2 years ago, I think. Well, it was stolen. The person that stole it got in an accident when the police tried to pull it over. And I had let my insurance lapse, which I think was probably one thing I had originally paid for. And so I have a judgment against me, and they suspended my license plate for not paying the payment arrangement. So all the time that they suspended it, I'd have to come up with $500 to get it back. So it would go with the judge to sign the papers to get that.
Okay.
So, like I said, I can't...
So those were some of the expenses that you were... Did you ever think it would get as bad as it did?
And to be honest, I had, before the accusations even came up, I had stopped. And I had been going around in my head how I was going to do this. I wanted to sell it home for what I did. And then it just got out of hand. And then my job got to the point where I couldn't even work my shifts at the office. I wasn't there half the time when I was supposed to be. And you just feel like everybody knows anyway what you did.
Sure.
I felt like that for years.
You mentioned you started in 99 with the city. When did this kind of begin?
Like I said, I've been working for a couple of years. I can't really pinpoint. It just seems like everything's gone too fast the last few years that I can't even timeline everything right now.
Was there a point within the last year and a half or so where you paid some of it back?
No, I mean, I didn't. It was stupid little things, like I wouldn't turn in receipts for things I picked up. It was certainly not anything to compare to what the total was. And to be honest, I never sat and figured out the total because I was scared of what it was going to be.
Because
I knew it had gotten out of hand.
Did anyone ever give you permission to write checks to yourself or to do any of that? With the checks that you wrote to yourself, did you deposit them or cash them, or how did you?
I went to Walmart.
Okay, and?
I don't use a checking account or anything. I only have a Walmart prepaid card.
Okay. So, would you cash that check and then get like a Walmart card? I don't understand.
Oh, yeah, it's a card you always have.
Okay. Is it like a type of a credit card?
Yeah. It's a Visa. It's still a Visa.
Okay. So it's a Walmart but Visa.
It's prepaid and like, you know, my paycheck from my full-time job, it's like direct deposited.
Okay.
And you can use it. It's just like a credit card basically, except you can't like, say you want to set up something to be an automatic payment.
Mm-hmm.
You can't do that with this.
Okay.
You can't with a checking account or a
sure.
debit card.
Okay. Because of the prepaid portion of it. So as I understand it, with your regular paycheck and with any money from Carlos, you would go to Walmart, deposit it into this prepaid Visa card, and then you'd be able to use that as a credit card, okay, and pay bills or make purchases. Or, okay. Did anyone else know? Was there ever a time where you signed the check for anybody else?
Mm-hmm.
Did you sign the check in Marcia's name or in the mayor's name? Did you ever write anybody else's name on any checks?
You mean for actual reasons?
To yourself.
Oh, no. Did I forge their name?
Did you ever write anybody else's name?
No.
Okay. How would the process work? You said Marcia would be there on Monday and she would sign some checks. You'd come in Wednesday, you would sign. And then did they go to the mayor for signature?
Oh, the real one.
Okay. And then did anyone ever question you on, well, we've got a gap in these check sequences?
No. To be honest, the state auditors program is
okay. And is this a program, a computer program?
Yeah.
Okay.
So, I mean, as sad as it is to say, it would be just not to nobody look at it, but
okay.
It's just a simple report, so it's not like, I don't know. They trusted me, and they had no reason to look because I used to be interested in
So tracking-wise, from the city's perspective, you took care of all of that. You tracked the checks, and you tracked the income and the expenses. And
the only thing is that Marcia I have to do the bank book every month,
mm-hmm.
and then I make copies of the bank book and the bank statement. And then I run a receipts register and a disbursements register for the month. And then I give her copies of all that, and she has to do the same bank record. And of course, I run a state auditor report for the year, and it asks for what the balance is, and then it also asks what the quick claims balance is.
Okay.
And I guess the only way Marcia would have seen my name because I didn't put the check for them under my name.
Okay. How did you do that?
I would just pick a different vendor.
Okay.
She didn't really see it. And then after that month was over, it just never was an issue.
So once you were through that month, then you just had the knowledge that no one was going back to look through. And is it fair to say that you're an accountant, you've got the knowledge of how this stuff works, and so you were able to manipulate the computer program and the books for your benefit?
No, I mean, I didn't really. I lied.
Okay.
But it's not an accounting person that would know how to do that. Anybody
okay.
can do that.
So the program wasn't that,
it's not that
detailed where someone couldn't do that? Okay. Do you think it's the fault of the computer program?
It's not the fault of anybody but me. I'm just saying that it's not a high-tech community that's coming up, and it just doesn't really take them. They have to be working with someone like Carlos. It's not the auditor's fault. It's not the commercial's fault, and it's not the council's fault, because they put trust in me that I've been doing a job for how long. I'm the one who's in the truck.
Do you think that there's, had there been some more protections in place, would you have been able to do this?
Very well.
Okay. So, and I'm not blaming anybody.
No, I'm not.
I'm just saying that had there been other things in place where Marcia would have done more checking, or others on the council, had there been more checks and balances, I guess, would have prevented you from... And that's where the opportunity came up, for you knowing that.
It wasn't even that. It really was. I got so far into it, I didn't know how to get out. I really, truly didn't know how to get out. I almost thought that at one point I remember thinking if I could just get all my bills paid, then all my paycheck pretty much could start going back to the city. Because, you know, that never happens. You never sitting there going, okay, everything's totally debt-free, now I can start paying them back.
Mm-hmm. Well, if you figure out how to make that happen,
obviously I
didn't. Write a book and let everyone know, because there'd be a lot of people interested, I think, so.
I think I just thought I could get far enough ahead. I kept it just a few more times where I'd be able to start putting them on.
And was that your goal?
I never wanted it to get to be that much. I never wanted it to go on as long as it did. And I had every intention of trying to pay it back. I honestly tried to find how you get black market loan sharks. And I did everything I could to try to figure out how to fix
it. And you mentioned a little bit ago that you were kind of afraid to figure out how much it was.
Well, back then, honestly, I didn't have the time either. I mean, I was in there so little. But by the time I knew that it had gotten out of hand, I just never sat and took the time. I couldn't even stand, even being in that office, because I knew what I'd done. And my work was suffering because of it, too.
And when you say that, you couldn't even stand to be guilt-wise, you were feeling guilty about it.
Yeah. I'm not the same person I was before I did this.
I understand you work at some type of a medical clinic, is that?
No. It's a corporate office that owns 11 nursing homes and 75 stability homes.
Okay.
And the corporate
hires all of the accounts. And are you an accountant for this company?
Payroll specialist. Okay. I was an accounting supervisor during the time of my son and my twins and all that. I stepped down because of that. And
okay.
He also had gotten in legal trouble. He tried to commit suicide. That's when things got worse.
anything else that you think I should know?
I want to make it safe. I just don't know how to do that without losing everything. I still have 10 teenage kids to be over for. I'm going to better spend to my brother. So I don't vote.
Well, I think you can look at this as the beginning to doing that, because I think you'll be able to walk out of here and go, it's out there. You don't have to hide from it anymore. You don't have to pretend like it didn't happen. Now's your chance to say, okay, what do I need to do to start making things right and start going in the other direction? You're always going to have your family. That won't change. Belongings and possessions, yeah, that's probably going to change. So, I think, you know, you say it, your own words, I want to make things right. Now is your chance to go forward and do that. I don't have any additional questions for you. Time now is 15:45. Turn off the recorder. I thank you for coming in. I'm sure it was very difficult for you to do that. I'm sure you've probably been wondering, you know, when's the knock on the door coming, or, you know, when's it going to
be jumpy all the time?
When's it going to come back to me? From here, this big fun packet is the auditor's office report. A lot of what's in there are copies of the checks that were written to yourself. I've got a report that I need to finish based on our conversation. It'll go to the county attorney's office. They will review it and decide on criminal charges.
Was there ever a time when you can be criminally charged without it ever being all over the place?
Well, what do you mean by all over the place?
In the papers, the radios, and somebody gets around.
You know, we don't necessarily have control of the media. Once a person is criminally charged with something, it becomes public data. Around here, the media doesn't come and look through our reports and such. And well, like car crashes and that kind of stuff, is that what you mean?
Anything. I mean,
in
people
those,
that beat somebody up or murder.
Sure. In those cases, they're typically pretty high-profile cases. And in something like that, we will put out a press release that says that, you know, last night there was a head-on crash because of the icy roads. We're going to notify the press of that. This is not something that we do press releases on.
They don't get to, like, so, look at the court documents.
Anybody could once it's public, but the media around here, they just don't do that anymore. You know, it used to be probably 10 years ago, the newspaper used to go and look through that stuff and publish it, and that just doesn't happen anymore. So,
well, I mean, I know you.
It's not something that I'm going to do, but like I say, once the county attorney's office reviews it and files criminal charges, it then becomes public, and anybody could get access to that. But our office, the county attorney's office, isn't going to be calling anybody and saying, hey, look at this story.
I know it seems like a lot of people want, obviously nobody wants everybody to know, and I know it probably seems like I'm doing it for myself.
Well, and you have a valid concern, and I understand that.
I will get fired, because it's
okay.
Going to be a felony, right?
Yeah.
And I can't make this right if I don't have a job.
Well, it's the other part of that, though. The initial criminal charge, you're probably looking at a felony level offense. Now, that's not to say that
that's what you would be convicted of, unless you went in right away and said, I plead guilty to it. You know, if you went through the court process, there's possibilities to lower that.
What are the amounts that make it a difference?
It's based on the dollar amounts, but those are just for the charging and the conviction stuff. So not everybody is convicted of the crime that they're charged with. You know, it happens fairly often that there's plea agreements that, you know, lowers or lessens that information. So right now I can't, you know, once my reports are done and it goes to the county attorney's office, kind of beyond my control. What I can do, what I do have control over, is to say that I contacted Bambi, wanted to visit with her. She was cooperative. She came in. She sat down with me for 45 minutes. We had a conversation. She told me what she did. That shows cooperation. And judges and attorneys see that and go, okay, this isn't the person who does it and then lies about it. This is the person who truly knows they made a mistake and now wants to make things better. And I tell kids, I'm a DARE instructor, so I'm in the schools too, and I tell kids, you know, these fifth and sixth graders, that more often than not, it's what you do after you screw up that people remember. Do you lie and say, no, I never did it? Or do you say, sorry, I did it, what do I need to do to make things better? That's where you get your reputation.
And, you know, probably like a stupid question, but I'm sure what the answer is. Being of my brother's a sheriff, he won't, like, be in trouble with his job or anything.
He's not in any trouble.
Yep,
no, this doesn't involve him whatsoever. No one is going to look at this and go, oh, you know, because unfortunately we all have siblings. That some of us would rather say, that doesn't look very well, but so, no.
Oh, that's the worst
no
part
concern.
My brother is always so nice for me.
And you know what? I'm willing to bet that maybe some disappointment, but he's still going to be there for you. Because we all make mistakes, and we all do things that we go, I should have done that.
So good.
Well, and you probably have some explaining to do. He's probably going to ask.
Well, that's the other thing.
You know,
will I know, like, before I get charged? Like, will the county...
You'll probably get a letter in the mail to appear in court.
And charged?
Yeah, that you've been charged with this offense. And you have a court date of this day and time is how you are going to be notified of it. In this case, it's, like I said at the beginning, when we're done here, you're getting up, and you're going about your day, and I'm going about mine. I'm not taking you to jail. At some point, the county attorney's office isn't going to say that we're charging her with this. She needs to be arrested. That won't happen. So long as you respond to any correspondence you get for court stuff, so long as you respond to those, you won't have to worry about that.
Is this... I don't know how this works for the city. Is this like a county thing now that they were not gonna, like, they're not going to be charging the city, right? The city doesn't have to pay lawyer fees for this stuff, or is it?
Not that I'm aware of. No, this is on you personally. So
I know it's stupid.
City,
I just don't want them to have to spend more money to do.
Sure. From what's been determined, from what I understand from the auditor's office, is that there is no liability on their part.
Right.
Although it's pretty, there's a couple of paragraphs in here that are rather scathing to the council for things that the checks and balances that we talked about, things that they should have been to trust or not. There's things they should have been doing, and some that don't even involve this and you. Some of the stuff in there. With transferring money and how they're supporting some of the, I can't think of the term, like the Boy Scouts and that, they do some of those things that they're not supposed to be doing, so
Which is unfortunate because as we look at it, we live in small rural communities, and we go, what a great thing that we're able to support these different programs, and yet the state says, but we've got these guidelines that it doesn't fit the criteria for how we're supposed to be spending our dollars. So, so there's some things that the city and council need to address, one, to prevent this from happening, and you even said it, had they had some checks and balances in place, you probably could have got about 2 months out of this, and then it would have, you know.
Well, enough, I mean, I know the difference. Like I said, we have an annual audit on the forefront job. We've done a lot of work getting ready.
Yeah.
I mean, we have accounting supervisors, like CFO, with you. And like I said, it's not anybody's fault. It's just as we come, you can see the difference.
Sure.
I guess it doesn't mean anybody should be confused. Yeah.
Well, you got in a bind. I think you tried to do what you, to make it okay for your family, and then it just kept on going, and you couldn't get back to where you wanted it to be, and like you say, you've had to live with kind of this guilt. For February 11 was kind of the beginning of it all, according to the records in here, so. A lot of life circumstances, and so.
Well, thank you. I'm sorry. I took so long. I'd like to, my voice now.
Okay. Yep. And you know what? I've only had this report for about 2 weeks, and I left a couple messages, and then
that's what said he did too.
When I swung by the house and left my card in the door there, and like I say, I truly will put in my report that you were very cooperative with me, and as soon as we connected, we got it taken care of, and that's
not
our
fault. I didn't know if I needed to bring it over.
I don't know.
But I'm not trying to hide it.
Sure. Well, probably from here on out, you certainly want to check into that, and
do I have to
do
all
that.
The same stuff, or can we?
Well, they're going to want to know.
Well, I know, but I mean, do they get to see the same statement I gave you?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yep. Your attorney could request all of the information that we, everything, and what's in this packet is just the written summary from the auditor's office and the copies of all the checks that were written. So, yeah, they would have access to all of that, our conversation, so to be able to know. And, like I say, at the same time, when you have a your first court appearance, you'd be able to certainly apply for a public defender as well. Then you have to fill out some forms about what assets you have, and you may qualify for a public defender at no cost. So that's certainly a possibility.
But in, even though this is a criminal big thing, we don't actually have to go through a whole trial process, right?
No, ultimately that's up to you.
It's just more of me doing my thing, getting a lawyer, and then I'm working it out because I'm not really...
Exactly. And, yeah, your options are, to work out some kind of an agreement with the county attorney's office and your attorney to say, okay, here's what we're going to do. Or you say, you know what, I think we'll try a judge or a jury trial. So those are your options in getting it resolved. The bottom line in it all, just so you know, it's a 10-year felony because of the dollar amount, and you were within about $300 and some of a 20-year felony. $35,000 would have been that next.
What's the jail time?
10-year felony.
Oh, that's
it. Yeah, that's no.
I thought you meant it was like you have to be watched for 10 years.
That's what it is. Now, is that going to happen? Probably not. I mean, you don't have a criminal record of, having done this before or any other stuff like that. So the maximum is most likely not going to apply in this case. I can't say that for sure, but in a lot of the other stuff that we deal with, maximums rarely apply. So.
But I will go to
I can't say that you won't.
So there's never been a case where somebody doesn't cure any kind, is there? Do you know?
I don't know.
I'm just curious.
Yeah, I don't know the answer to that. And that's why I say, if you can't get a public defender, get yourself an attorney, you know, so they know what can and can't be worked out, you know, whether that can be avoided or whether you might have to, you know, spend some time in there and to do.
I mean, it's not like it would suck, but
yeah.
It's just that, because I don't have, kids don't actually, like, really have a dad anymore, so that would cause a problem.
Sure.
So.
Well, and I would think that some of that would be considered as well, that, you know, there's, we got to have a caregiver for these children. So.
Yeah.
And again, this isn't, you know, no one died because of this, and so we're not at that stage where, well, sorry, you know, that's, it would be, I can't say unlikely, but maybe less likely. I think one thing you'll be able to do is take a big deep breath and go, okay, what do I need to do next, you know, and such. When I talked to Dustin the other day, I said that I was meeting with you today. I told him it was about a theft and it was a substantial amount of money. And I said, that's kind of what I'm going to tell you. Now, he's got the ability to go in and read reports, so if he chooses to do that, stop him from doing that, and it's up to you if you want to share with him. Fine. If you don't want to, you don't have to.
No, I have to.
Sure. Well, probably the hard part is over with because he's aware of it, you know. So now that, at least that part of the conversation is out there, and however you two decide to deal with it is up to you. You know, bottom line, he's your brother. He loves you. He cares for you. He'll do what he can to help you, and you know, certainly stand by you and say, well, that was really dumb, but he'll still probably stand right next to you and help you however he can. And it will not. And the other thing, you talked about Marcia. And that she probably doesn't like you anymore. She had two comments. She said she was mad.
Yeah.
And that she was sad. But at the same time, I think if you called her and talked to her, I think that friendship you two had for many years would probably override, you know, what's been done. She seemed to be, to me, that was, she was sad that, you know, that it happened to the money, and mad that you kind of took advantage of that, but I don't necessarily know that she's specifically mad at you, the person, mad about what you did. Well, you know, when she mentioned, too, it kind of just came to an abrupt end, and that was about July or August of this year, and it sounded like you two used to text frequently, and she said it just kind of stopped, and you ran into each other at Walmart just before school started, and she said it was kind of an awkward conversation, but you talked about the kids and going back to school and that, so.
Yeah, I mean, I can tell her why I had stopped going. Like I said, I don't want her to know until, I don't want anybody to know, because I was afraid it would put them in a position of knowing and not doing anything about it. But like I said, I did stop before I stopped going to work, taking my room.
Well, I think however you choose to communicate with her, I my sense, and I just met with her for about an hour, so I don't know her other than that, but my sense is that, you know, I think you two can still have a
Well, and remember that you made a mistake, you know, and don't think that everyone is going to hate you because of that. And yeah, certainly you're going to feel some embarrassment and all of that, but you know, I think good people can overcome that too and say, you know what, sorry you were in a bad spot and you thought this was the way to do it. And,
so. Yeah, like I said, I'm not very concerned about me. I've never had them always felt. They're tough times to keep going. They've been through so much, so it's just ridiculous. So much fun family has to go through in life, and I mean, compared to some other people, it's nothing. All right. Well, thank you. I appreciate it.
Well, thanks for coming in. I appreciate that, and I'm glad we were able to get it resolved. Like we say, some resolution. For you and let me give you my card. If you have questions about anything or wonder where what happened. No. Rarely things work fast around here.
Okay.
I would guess probably came over to yeah. And I not a big deal.